Do you get stressed in social situations? Do you get a little nervous or extremely anxious? In this video, I want to talk about the difference between social anxiety and social stress. My name is Vanessa Van Edwards, and I'm a recovering awkward person. This means the tiny bit of nervousness in any social situation makes me terribly awkward. So I have come up with all kinds of tips and tricks in my human behavior lab, The Science of People, to battle it. The question is that social anxiety or is that normal social stress? The actual definition of social anxiety is that the fear of interaction with other people brings on self-consciousness, feelings of being negatively judged and evaluated, and as a result, leads to avoidance of social interactions. In the US, recent studies have found that social anxiety disorder is the third largest psychological disorder in the country, after depression and alcoholism. It's estimated that about 7% of the population suffers from some form of social anxiety. The lifetime prevalence rate for developing social anxiety disorder is 13 to 14%. That's a lot of people, but not all social anxiety is created equal. Localized versus generalized anxiety. Most people have localized social anxiety about very specific social situations, say public speaking or romantic situations. Think about times you have been socially anxious. Is there a pattern? Did it happen in the same place with the same kind of activity or the same people? Here are the most common situations people experience social anxiety. Speaking in front of a large group, talking to strangers, being the center of attention, like when you're hosting a dinner, speaking to authority figures, like your boss, answering the phone, eating or drinking in front of others, talking to someone you find attractive. If you just have anxiety with these specific areas, that would be localized anxiety. General social anxiety happens with any and all social interactions and is a bit more rare. Social anxiety is not just about sweaty palms. It actually involves four components. The four components of social anxiety. People often think social anxiety is just a feeling, but it actually has four components: thoughts, feelings, physical sensations, and behaviors. Have you ever noticed that your nervousness is accompanied by physical symptoms like trembling, sweating, or blanking out? When you're anxious, the four components interact with and build upon each other, causing a cycle of anxiety. For example, here's how your anxiety might manifest itself if you're nervous about giving a presentation at work. Thoughts. Often, your anxiety will begin with a negative thought, like, I'm gonna screw up, or people will think I'm stupid. Feelings. These thoughts cause you to feel negative emotions, like stress or worry. Physical response. Your body reacts to your negative thoughts and feelings with a physical response, like blushing, sweating, or shaking. Behaviors. To reduce your anxiety, you do conscious or unconscious things like averting your gaze or hiding behind the podium to prevent people from seeing you shake. Acting this way may make you think everyone else notices you look stiff, an anxious thought, which can cause you then to feel even more stressed, an anxious feeling. Do you see how this can become a cycle? Let me explain how this works in the body. The science of social anxiety. In the book Wired to Connect, authors Amy Banks and Leanne Hirschman present some fascinating science behind social anxiety. They say that people with social anxiety often have difficulty with their smart vagus nerve. The smart vagus helps us know when we are safe. It keeps us nice and calm. But sometimes, if we've had a bad social interaction in the past, it misfires and it makes it even harder for us to stay calm, cool, and collected. You know if your smart vagus nerve misfires when a number of things happen. You physically can't see or hear people as well. You have trouble interpreting facial expressions. You can't make as much eye contact as your eyes dart around the room. You become less expressive and aren't as responsive with smiles or laughs, which makes you come across as hostile or angry or aloof. You have an elevated heart rate, sweaty palms, a hard time breathing, dry mouth, and fuzzy brain. In other words, you feel anxious, get a physical response that causes behaviors that make it even harder for you to be charismatic and liked. And this makes you think you're unlikable and uncharismatic. This horrible cycle can be caused by the smallest thing and can ruin your whole night. Someone cuts you off on the highway, someone forgets your name, you think your boss looks at you funny. Any of those small cues can set off this cycle, and by the end of the night or day, you're exhausted and miserable. Sound familiar? What happens next? If this cycle has happened to you, you might have noticed one of the three behaviors that happens next. There are three types of behaviors that people with social anxiety tend to exhibit. 1. Avoidance behaviors make you stay away from situations that make you anxious. For example, you might turn down opportunities to give presentations at work, or say no to a party invitation. Escape behaviors, when you leave situations that make you anxious, like leaving a concert or party after just a few minutes because of your anxiety. Lastly, safety behaviors, actions you take to reduce your anxiety in social situations, like drinking to feel more comfortable, or playing a game on your phone at lunch. In the examples above, averting your gaze or sticking nervously to the podium during a presentation are safety behaviors. What can you do about social anxiety? If you think you have social anxiety, the most important question to ask yourself is whether it prevents you from achieving your goals. For example, do you turn down opportunities at work? Do you have trouble dating or building rapport with new colleagues? If your fear is keeping you from getting the promotion you want, or getting in the way of an important personal goal, like giving a speech at your sister's wedding, then you might consider looking for help. The most common way to treat is with cognitive behavioral therapy, also known as CBT. This is widely recognized as the most effective treatment for social anxiety. It's endorsed by National Institute of Mental Health, NIMH, and the National Health Service, NHS. CBT is based on the idea that it's not a social situation that makes you anxious, but your interpretation of that situation. For example, if you're having dinner with a friend and she leaves early, you can interpret this in several ways. You might think she found dinner with you boring, leading you to feel anxious. Or you might think she had a long day and was tired, and then you feel neutral. People with social anxiety tend to interpret situations in a disproportionately negative way. CBT teaches you to recognize and embrace the existence of alternate interpretations, allowing you to identify if there are other possible explanations that are less likely to trigger your anxiety. Tips for dealing with social anxiety. Here are some CBT-based tips for dealing with anxiety in the moment. First, remember everyone is self-conscious. Social anxiety is common and many people experience it. If you're at a party and feel really anxious about introducing yourself to new people, remember that other people might feel the exact same way. 2. Pause to examine the evidence. When you're feeling anxious, take a moment and try to identify the anxious thoughts running through your head. Challenge them by asking questions like, "What evidence do I have that makes this true?" And "Is there another explanation for what happened?" If someone responds curtly to you, you may have the anxious thought that, ugh, they think I'm boring. But what if you challenged that thought and instead considered another explanation? Maybe they were in a hurry, or maybe they were already on their way to talk to someone else, or maybe they had a bad day. 3. Imagine the worst case scenario. Often, people with social anxiety think making a mistake will cause far worse consequences than it actually would. If you're worried about something like stumbling over your words, ask, what would really happen if you did stumble over your words? Would people really laugh at you? They'd probably barely notice it or quickly forget about it and continue the conversation. 4. Remind yourself anticipation is worse than reality. Often, our worries about an upcoming situation are far worse than the situation itself. If you're worried about striking up a conversation because you think you'll have nothing to say, remind yourself that you only have to start with hello. And once you begin the conversation, it gets a lot easier. 5. Bring a cheat sheet. Before going into an anxiety-inducing situation, anticipate what anxious thoughts you'll have and challenge them on a piece of paper. Bring this slip of paper with you to the event or save it on your phone. So if you start feeling nervous, you can look at it to remind yourself of your thought challenges and calm yourself down. 6. Consider getting help. If you find social anxiety is really impacting your life or getting in the way of your career or relationships, you might want to get help from a professional. I recommend searching your area for someone who specializes in CBT for social anxiety. You could also try an online program like Joyable that uses CBT therapy with online coaches. Here's the bottom line. Just get help. The shocking truth is that 85% of Americans who struggle with social anxiety each year don't get help, even though we have proven ways to help. If you think you have social anxiety, please talk to someone. Don't struggle alone because you are not alone. Thank you so much for watching this video on this topic. I wish we talked more about it. Remember, you are not alone. Know someone who needs to see this video? Please send it to them and offer to talk through anything that comes up. You might be sending it at just the right time.